This is a really interesting development. In fact, a lot of our audience will be probably surprised that it's taken to this point to have the first school district all-electric fleet. Just explain the deal that you've done with Oakland.
Thank you, Ed, for having me. I'm excited to be here. So electric school bus is having a moment right now. Oakland Unified will be the first major school district in the country to be 100% electric. And we have enabled this by a few things. First, there is a tremendous support of the grants, including the Clean School Bus Initiative Act and the local level grants that are available in accelerating the energy transition. And the second thing very unique about this is that all 74 buses are enabled with bidirectional charging, plugged into our V2G platform, can supply energy back to the grid when these buses are not used for transportation, which is typically in the evenings and summer, which is also a peak demand of energy. So it is pretty amazing, given the Oakland community is really affected by the poor quality of air and the asthma rates. This is a tremendous opportunity.
We were just looking at the scale of where Zoom operates around the country. This morning, the team were also kind of crunching the numbers on how far there still is to go. So when you think about U.S. school districts, I make it that there's about 500,000 school buses, you know, across the country, and many of them still run on diesel. So if that's true, you've got a long way to go to electrify. How is that pace going to play from here?
Yeah, absolutely. Zoom actually today is in 14 states, serving 4,000 plus schools across the country and expanding nationally quite rapidly. So the fundamental foundation and playbook that we have developed in Oakland using our V2G technology and the entire playbook for electrifying the buses and working with all the partners in the ecosystem can be now extended and be available to all the other districts. Typically, people were doing just one or two pilots or deployments at very low scale. With this kind of a deployment now, the news is very positive for the other districts across the nation.
Where does the money come from to electrify school fleets?
So you'll be surprised to know that electric school buses are still 2 to 3 times more expensive than the diesel buses.
Wow.
And that is one of the reasons that the adoption has not been so much faster. And what Zoom has been able to do this deployment at scale because of multiple reasons. One is there are tremendous support available from the federal and state grants that is enabling us to reduce the cost of the buses. And second is electric school bus is actually the largest battery on wheels. It is 4 to 6 times Tesla battery with a very predictable local commute pattern, and it's not used for transportation in the peak demand of energy. There's no other asset which has such a unique pattern. And this allows us to give energy back to the grid and reduce the price of the bus and bring it at par with diesel buses.